home rejoicing because of this new Beyonce bop.
Oh my god.
If you have not seen the video, you better see the video because it's literally a cinematic masterpiece.
It brought me back to life. I haven't seen a video that... What?
Sorry.
No, it's okay. Go ahead.
I do have a couple problems with it.
Let's get into
just it. Like, the whole, like, light skin, dark skin thing is still in effect a little bit. She does have a couple clips from, like, I want to say, like, olden time, like, New Orleans, kind of. I mean, there's our particular still where, like, Blue Ivy is, like, rocking her afro. And there's, like, two, like, black girls beside her. And, like, a lot of people are saying, like, oh, like, she's, like, about to pull another Beyonce, like, in Destiny's Child. Like, Kelly and Michelle are right next to her. And I'm just like, all right, okay. But if you see the little black girls, it's like, Blue Ivy is the light-skinned one. Right. And then, like, those little black girls are, like, they're obviously darker skin than she is. And they look very, like, somber. And I personally feel like I have a problem with that. I know, like, I am a mixed person. I just feel like, I don't know, maybe it's a little out of touch. Maybe, I don't know. It's a little questionable for me right now. Right. In terms of that, there's also, what was it? They were saying that she stole clips from a documentary on New Orleans that she did not ask for the rights for. She just
is kinda... that like the audio that was in it and yeah. the shots of New Orleans and stuff after Hurricane Katrina, I'm assuming.
Yeah. So yeah. I mean, like, that's kind of a touchy subject, being an artist, you know, especially with Tidal, because, like, I mean, like, nobody wants to pay for Tidal, you know what I mean?
Nobody wants to pay for Tidal.
But, I mean, they still keep going and funneling their money into it, but, like, what about the artists who create that you want a piece of their art and they don't have money to protect it in the right ways and you steal it from them, you know what I mean? Like, where are your morals lying as an artist as big as you are? That's my question. Her, but what were you gonna
say
for it?
No, I mean, I like the song, it was very catchy. You put up a lot of good points. I thought it was interesting. She was on top of the cop car, and that one scene where that one boy was dancing in front of, like, all the armed guards, they put their arms up and said, "Stop shooting us." I feel like if she was gonna put that in the video, she could have definitely put at the end of it, like, a link to a page to support, you know, like, the Black Lives Matter campaign. I feel like she kind of missed the mark on that. Not saying she's obligated to do it, but I'm saying, like, if you're gonna make that statement in a video, go with it. Don't just put it in for aesthetics, you know?
Right. I mean, I feel like a lot of people are saying that, like, oh, like, Kendrick said in a song to stop shooting us and nobody said anything. But when Beyonce says it, everybody's like, slay, oh my god. And there's a problem with this because many black men in general, many rappers in general, don't believe that, like, you can be, like, socially conscious and then also, like, intersectionally, you know what I mean? Like, there's somebody wrote on the infamous black Twitter that I love to be on, there's a reason why, like, they chose Beyonce as opposed to Kendrick. You know what I mean? Because she is, like, with this song, she's being unapologetically black. And it's okay that she is unapologetically black. Like, she's kind of, like, enforcing this whole, like, carefree black girl thing, which I love. I mean, like, because in so many parts of our, of my life as a mixed person, as a black person, it's hard for me to be carefree. It's very easy for me to be angry. It's very easy for people to look at me and be like, oh, she's an angry black girl. You know what I mean? Yeah. Because one thing will set me off and that's how people look at me. You know what I mean? So the fact that she's being so unapologetic about herself, about, like, Black Lives Matter, about Hurricane Katrina, about her daughter Blue, about the, like, the Illuminati stuff,
yes.
Like,
oh,
all of that, like, is so, like, enriching and so awesome. There obviously are setbacks, as I previously stated, but I love the fact that she's asserting herself into the black community, because I feel like white people for a long time were like, I love Beyonce, oh my god. And, like, the one thing that I have as a problem is that people are like, oh, like, this song isn't for white people. And, like, that's a touchy subject to me, because I'm like, why not? If somebody enjoys a song, regardless of how they enjoy it, shouldn't you praise the fact that they're enjoying it, period?
Yeah, I'm half white. I love this song.
I'm not from the South, So I can't, like, relate to a lot of things that are in this video, but I'm totally here for it. You know what I mean? Like, that's what solidarity is. That's what support is. You know what I mean? Like, you have, if you have a platform that you can speak about something and give way to, like, educating other people through your platform, why would you not do that? You know?
Exactly.
But I feel like some white people on the internet somewhere are saying they have problems with Beyonce's new video. And that's where I feel like people are like, then this video isn't for you, which is kind of true. You know what I mean? Like,
why do you have problems as a white person? Why do you have problems with a black female artist making a video about being unapologetically carefree and black? You know what I mean? Like, why do you as a white person take offense to that? Like, I don't understand that.
Well, I mean, we could totally get into a topic about white supremacy, but we're not going to do that today.